Welcome to Counseling with Juliet. Happy Sunday. How is everything? I hope everything is going well. I just want to drop this to motivate and to elevate our spirit this hour, wherever you are watching me from. I want to be talking about what are you expecting. A lot of us are expecting a lot of things, and we know what happened the beginning of this year till the time we are now. So a lot of people feel that maybe their expectations might not be met because of what has gone wrong. But let me tell you, expectation is something that you actually have to really look at and look it deeply, because why at times a lot of us make a mistake from where we expect from. And frustration normally comes in whenever you have put in a lot of effort has been put in and you are seeing little or no results. It causes frustration, causes disappointment, because why? You have actually put your efforts, and at the end you are seeing that nothing is actually coming out of what you are expecting or what you expect to see. So let me just tell you that the first question I want to actually ask you, because I know that we are all expecting a lot of things this year, and seeing what has gone, what has happened, and we are like, are we still going to see those things that we are expecting? Are we still going to meet up with our expectation? I want to ask you a question. Number one, who are you expecting from? Because it has a lot to do with what you will see at the end result of what you are expecting. Who are you expecting from? A lot of people are expecting, but they are not expecting from the God that has created them, that can actually provide those things for them. Who are you expecting from? Because if you put your trust in man, the Bible said man will fail. He said, woe unto that one that puts his trust in man. So if you put your trust, if whatever you are expecting is depend on a man, I assure you that you might not meet up to that expectation. You might not meet up to what you are expecting to see at the end of this year. So who are you expecting for? You understand? The Bible said in Jeremiah 29:11, he said, the thoughts that I have towards you and I are thought of good and not of evil, to bring us to an expected end. So God has already provided an expected end for me and you. So it now depends on who you are putting your hope on. Who are you expecting it from? Are you expecting it from your brother? Are you expecting it from your friends? Are you expecting it from even your church members? Let me tell you, it might not come, because why? If you divert your expectation from the Almighty God, you might not see results, and it will cause frustration. And also, I will also ask you, what are your expectations? You will see a lot of people today, they will tell you they are expecting a lot of things, but if you ask them, they don't even know what they are expecting. What are your expectations? Are your expectations in line with what God has said? Are your expectations in line with God's words? You also have to check that, because if you are expecting something and that whatever you are expecting is not in line with what God has prepared for you in 2020, this year that we are, you might not see it. So first of all, bend down and ask in prayer, in searching the word of God, what are the expectations of God for me this year? So that you know what you base your expectation on. So what are you expecting? What are you expecting? Sit down and think about, what am I expecting to achieve this year before you know what to do? And I want to tell you, I also want to ask you this, you that is expecting, what effort have you made? What have you put in so much to expect so much? It is a question that we all have to ask ourselves. What have you put in so much to expect so much? A lot of people expect much. They expect big things. They expect to see great things, but they are putting very little efforts. They are not working hard by achieving that thing. They just believe that they start professing it, and they are not doing anything about it. And at the end of the day, you find that the person is still in the same place. So what have you put in? What have you put in for you to be expecting so much? Have you put in prayers? Have you put in praise and worship? Have you put in giving? Have you even put in, interceding for somebody? Remembering others in your prayers? You should know what you should put in to get what you're expecting. So depends on what you're expecting, it also depends on what you will get. Let me tell you, life does not give you what you desire. Life gives you what you demand. So whatever you are demanding from life, make sure you put a lot to achieve it. If you are putting so little and you are expecting much, it might not come, and it can also cause disappointment and frustration. So I just want to encourage you out there. If you are the one that I'm talking to, I don't know who I'm talking to this hour, but I'm being led in my spirit to tell you that your expectation shall not be cut off. No matter what you are expecting, no matter what has gone wrong, no matter what has passed, and you feel that all hope is lost, I've come to give you hope. Don't lose hope, because God has not given up in you. God still loves you, and he's still ready to do that which he has promised to give you. But it depends on what you want, and it depends on you. So what are you putting in your expectation? If you are there today, you don't know how to pray, start praying. If you are there and you need to touch God with your praise, with your worship, for your expectations to come to pass, what are you waiting for? Start it now. If you're also there that you need to touch souls that are dying in Africa or all over the world by sowing seed, by blessing them with the little you have, start doing that right now. God is about to meet your expectation. And if you're also there that you need to intercede for that person, begin to intercede for people. Talk to God about people's situation, and God will also be there to meet your situation. I think this word has blessed you wherever you are. And if you are the one, please don't hesitate to share and to like and to leave your comment. Thank you. Until I see you next time. Bye-bye.